Due to the labyrinthine halls nature of social media, Aries Spears, a comedian of considerable repute, has elected to voice his critique on a sartorial trend that has captivated many within the African-American community.
Yo, what up? It's your boy Aries Spears here. Ayo, quick public service announcement. To all my beautiful black queens out there, I want you to know from the bottom of my heart that I love you, I respect you. You're beautiful and you're mandatory. That being said, can some of y'all please, for the love of God, stop wearing the big fake eyelashes? You have no idea. Are you not aware of how ridiculous that looks to have this on your face? It looked like you got pterodactyl wings on your face. You don't need it. And if you're not proportioned correctly and you're as skinny as Snoop Dogg with this on your face, it's just a horrible look. Them eyelashes look like BBLs for your face. You don't need it. Love and respect. DM me for the link to the Spears and Steinberg podcast. Also subscribe to our YouTube channel under Spearsberg Pod. Hit like and subscribe. You don't need it. BBLs for the face.
His commentary on black women and their penchant for voluminous eyelashes was delivered with a blend of humor and earnestness, an endeavor to traverse the delicate balance between critique and commendation. As he extolled the inherent beauty and indispensability of black women, he concurrently decried what he perceived as an unnecessary and aesthetically discordant adornment. Aries Spears' articulation commenced with an unequivocal declaration of love and respect for black women, affirming their intrinsic beauty and societal significance. This preliminary adulation served as a strategic prelude to his subsequent critique, ostensibly cushioning the potential impact of his forthcoming observations. Such a rhetorical device is not uncommon, intended to convey a sense of solidarity and genuine concern rather than mere disparagement. The comedian's primary contention lay with the trend of oversized, artificial eyelashes, which he likened to an incongruous appendage on the visage. His vivid analogies, comparing the lashes to pterodactyl wings and facial BBLs, Brazilian butt lifts, underscore his perception of their exaggerated nature. From a liberal perspective, Spears' critique could be seen as an expression of personal taste and aesthetic preference, a subjective viewpoint that highlights the diversity of opinions within any cultural discourse. Conversely, from a leftist standpoint, his remarks might be scrutinized through the prism of societal norms and the pressures they exert on individual self-expression. The leftist critique would likely focus on the broader implications of policing personal appearance, especially within a marginalized community. It raises pertinent questions about autonomy, identity, and the influences that shape beauty standards. Spears' observations, while perhaps intended humorously, touch upon the deeper issues of self-perception and the external validation that drives certain aesthetic choices. Aries Spears' critique also implicitly addresses the cultural phenomenon of cosmetic enhancement and its impact on identity. The analogy of eyelashes as facial BBLs suggests a critique of the larger culture of cosmetic modification, which extends beyond mere aesthetics into the realms of self-worth and societal acceptance. This cultural critique is particularly salient in a society where appearance often intersects with issues of race, class, and gender. The notion of proportion that Spears introduces is not merely about physical symmetry but also about the congruity of personal style with one's inherent characteristics. His commentary invites a reflection on the nature of beauty and the pressures to conform to certain standards that may not align with individual authenticity. This reflection is crucial in understanding the dynamics of self-presentation within a community that has historically been subject to external judgments and stereotypes. Spears' exhortation for black women to embrace their natural beauty, eschewing what he perceives as unnecessary enhancements, can be seen as a call for empowerment. It suggests a return to an appreciation of intrinsic qualities over artificial augmentations, a sentiment that resonates with broader movements advocating for natural beauty and self-acceptance. However, this advocacy must be balanced with an understanding of personal agency and the right to self-expression. From a socio-cultural perspective, Spears' remarks highlight the ongoing dialogue within the African-American community about beauty standards and self-representation. This dialogue is not merely about aesthetics but also about identity, cultural pride, and resistance to homogenizing pressures. The comedian's critique, therefore, is part of a larger conversation about how individuals navigate their identities in a world that often imposes rigid norms. The humor inherent in Spears' delivery serves to soften the critique, making it more palatable and engaging. Humor has the power to disarm and provoke thought, allowing for a critique that might otherwise be dismissed or resisted. In this context, Spears' comedic approach can be seen as a means of broaching a sensitive topic in a manner that encourages reflection rather than defensiveness. However, the effectiveness of this approach depends on the reception by the audience, particularly those who feel directly targeted by the critique. It raises questions about the role of public figures in shaping cultural norms and the responsibilities that come with such influence. Spears' commentary thus becomes a microcosm of the broader dynamics of cultural critique and the complex interplay between intention and interpretation. In summation, Aries Spears' discourse on Black women's aesthetic choices is a multifaceted critique that straddles the line between humor and earnestness. It reflects broader societal debates about beauty, identity, and autonomy, inviting reflection on the pressures and norms that shape personal expression. While his intent may be to uplift and encourage authenticity, the reception of his message will inevitably vary, highlighting the nuanced and often contentious nature of cultural critique.